Welcome to Pillow Talk.
Are you okay?
Joseph, what are you doing?
Stop picking your nose and help the man up.
Oh, he's crying. The baby.
Probably better off.
Actually. Whoa. These colors are so vivid.
I can see my hands, they're not blurry anymore, so less pixelated.
I thought this shirt was yellow!
So did I!
What just happened?
Are we in HD?
No way!
Way, welcome to Pillow Talk, HD.
My shirt's yellow again!
Welcome to Pillow Talk. My name's Kiefer.
I'm Craig.
I'm John.
You got your page?
Yeah.
All right, let's have a bet it.
Alrighty. It's March 16th. And last night, I had a dream that I was with Linzo.
Why was Uncle Steve's a place to study?
It was just available, I guess.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Does he live nearby?
No, he lives 7 hours from here.
What a great place to study.
It was, yeah.
No. It was an isolation.
So we were both studying for tests, and as I was working, I felt something sharp slide down my back. Lindsay's pencil lead had snapped, so instead of throwing it out, she dropped it down my shirt.
It's not that sharp.
I wasn't pleased.
John's a baby.
Okay, I am not a baby. It was sharp.
You're raising your voice for no reason.
I am not raising my voice.
You're crying about a little
pencil. I'm not crying. Okay, so what I did, because I had to retaliate, I got all of my pencil lead, all the spare pencil lead, I don't know why I wasted all of it, but I broke it up into little pieces, went over behind Lindsay, put my hand up her shirt.
Okay, whoa. Okay,
the back rated or the front? Back or the front?
Back.
Okay. Hey, you still get stuff done in the back.
And then I wrapped my hand around and dropped all the pencil lead in her bra.
In the back of the bra?
Nope, in the cup. Just reached on it.
Why didn't you just drop it right down the front? I feel like that would have been much easier than me.
Now she's sexually violated and she's got lead in her bra.
I don't know if I'm okay with this.
She was kind of alarmed. When I put my hand up her shirt,
regardless if I'm wearing a bra or not, I would be a little upset too. A little alarmed.
She looked at me funny and I was just like, what? She's like, what are you doing with your hand up my shirt, you weirdo? And I was like, relax. Told her to relax. She relaxed. And then I dropped the bomb. So once she emptied all the lead out of her shirt, Oh, she freaked out, blah, blah, blah. And, we were gonna watch some TV before we went to bed. So we sat on the couch, and my dog, Pebbles, was there. She's a little last half, so.
Now, why is Pebbles at Steve's house? Is Steve, like, the normal dog sitter?
I guess we were just visiting, and my dog was with us. It's like, you know those show dogs with the really long hair that goes to the floor?
Oh, yeah.
It's like that, except we cut her hair.
It's like a street cleaner.
Yeah.
See one of those spinning in the front of the machine.
It's like that's just bad. So we started watching TV. My dog starts looking at us like she wants up on the couch, and I don't know. I usually let my dog up on the couch. She was excited to see Linzo, so
I wouldn't be.
I was
especially in that raging anger she was in.
Exactly, but my dog can't tell the difference between any sentimental emotion. Value, but I don't even know what I'm saying.
Okay.
She got really excited. I let her up. I did the whole. She jumped up. Shit all over the couch.
Like instant.
Like just yeah, and it was like hard.
Like
it
everywhere.
Well, all over.
No, just like up, just like on the couch, and I like reached my leg on the couch and just kind of like kicked her off. And it was really hard. It was like petrified almost instantly.
It was like over millions of years.
It was like that instant chocolate that you dip your Dairy Queen cone in.
Ew.
It dried that fast.
That's disgusting.
That's just gross.
Oh, Linzo freaked out again. The dog crapping on the couch. I kicked the crap off the couch and we watched some TV and then went to bed. I woke up from
the... Not on the couch.
No, it was on the floor.
So
now.
I woke up from the dream. So I had dreamed that.
Okay, so this wasn't the reality of the dream. This was...
That was a dream in my dream.
Inception.
Yes, so...
Real.
So I woke from the dream and started feeling really nervous. And I remember, because I was dreaming, I dreamed that I was studying for a test. I did actually have a test the next day.
But were you dreaming and then you... When you say you woke up, did you wake up in your second dream? Or did you actually wake up?
Okay, so...
All nervous.
So, Linzo is like the second derivative of my dream.
Okay.
I don't like math.
You're not going to explain it better with math. Okay, so when you woke up in a dream still. You were still dreaming,
yes.
But you thought you had woken up.
Yes.
Okay,
so,
there we go.
Okay.
There
no
we go.
Math.
No confusion. So, I was all nervous because I felt as though I'd missed my test. I looked at the 3 clocks in the... All the clocks in the TV room said a time between 12:30 and 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
This is just as confusing as Inception.
Yeah.
I was freaking out. I got up and ran to the kitchen, and I passed my sister in a lazy boy chair, and she was eating cereal, and I asked her what time it was, and she told me it was 8:30 in the morning. So I was like, oh, phew. Like, didn't miss my test.
Were you writing the test on campus? Because if you're 7 hours away, chances are you're still not going to make it.
So in my dream, campus was actually where my cottage was.
And where's your...
And so I was actually 20 minutes away from campus.
Okay.
At my uncle's house. So I hadn't slept in, which was good, but it was at my uncle's house, and I had no way of commuting to school. And my sister informed me that my aunt was going to drive us to school. So she also informed me that we were going to school together. And for some reason, I understood that Carlton was located where my cottage was, blah, blah, blah. I knew it would only take 20 minutes to get there. Oh, yeah. So I ran back, and I pulled out my pencil because I remembered the Linzo dream. So I wrote it down, and I remember writing the words, "We were in the TV room at Uncle Steve's." So I have this vivid image, this memory of me writing down on a table next to the couch. So I got called back into the kitchen for breakfast. My grandma was standing there talking to my aunt, who seemed a little flustered, but then she mentioned that she was talking to the cops. I was like, oh dear.
That was like Robert Munch.
What?
You're really engaging the viewers.
I felt bad, so I felt as though I had to ask why she was talking to the cops. It turned out my cousin, Scott, had been caught with possession of drugs, I assumed. And my Auntie Jo had to
bail
him out.
Sorry, time out. How many people are at your own
My aunt, Auntie Jo.
You have
Jo.
Your aunt, your uncle, your grandma. Are you having a family reunion?
I'm at my cousin's house. And so yeah, we went in for breakfast and blah, blah, blah. She spilled the story that Scott was caught with drugs. I didn't even know that he did drugs. He doesn't. So my aunt had to go bail him out, and at this point I woke up and realized I had a dream.
Alright, thanks for watching Pillow Talk. Remember to thumbs up,
comment,
subscribe.